Okay, I'd like to call to order the regular council meeting of September 12, 2016. Mr. Spagnuolo, would you please call the roll?
Vilela? Dixon?
Here.
Gibbons? Hannon?
Present.
Harrison?
Present.
McLean?
Here.
Mowry?
Here.
O'Brien?
We have six member. Mr. O'Brien has entered the room. We have seven members present. Before we stand up for the Pledge of Allegiance, I'd just like to let everybody know we'll be standing for a moment of silence. We had a passing one of our fellow council members this past week. So after the Pledge of Allegiance, if we can stand for a moment of silence for Councilman John Pape.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, at this time, I'd like to turn to chair announcements. We had an executive session of council was held on Monday, August 22, 2016, to discuss personnel items. And tonight, before we came out, I apologize, we're running a little late. We had executive session of council on September 12, 2016, for personnel and legal issues. At this time, can we turn to the reports of the officials and the library director's report?
Good evening, my name is Christine. I'm the director of Door Public Library. We provide services to inform, inspire, and enrich the community. During the month of August, we had just under 14,000 people visit the library. We had just under 2,000 people use one of the library's computers. An additional 716 people accessed our Wi-Fi network. We had 1,600 people attend one of the 126 programs that we offered during the month of August. We had just under 25,000 traditional items borrowed. That's books, DVDs, CDs, audiobooks, magazines, an additional 2,400 that borrowed eBooks. And also, I just wanted to say thank you to the 872 participants in our summer reading program this year. It was, we had a great time. We had a lot of good programs. And we had some winners. I don't have their names with me. We had some raffles during the summer. Some programs of highlight, story times have begun again, as it is September. So toddler story time is on Tuesday at 10:00 and 10:30. Mother Goose on the Loose is on Wednesdays at 9:30, 10:30, and 11:30. Baby Jam is on Thursdays at 9:30 and 10:30. We have many, many other programs for birth through teen years that the Youth Services Department hosts. Programs for adults, our Coloring for Grownups group will start again on Tuesday, September 20th at 7:00 p.m. We have Dr. Timothy Campbell with us on Wednesday, September 21st at 7:00 p.m. for a new approach to weight loss. This was, he was here in the spring, and it was standing room only, so we're bringing him back. And we have a climate change talk on Thursday, September 22nd at 7:00 p.m. And a new program that we have started is called Memory Cafe. This group will meet on the fourth Wednesday of the month at 10:00 a.m. This is coffee and conversation specifically geared for those with dementia and their caregiver. So we'll have two resource professionals on hand, one to discuss topics of interest to caregivers, such as caregiver burnout and some of the resources that are available for caregivers. And the other resource professional will be available to provide activities for those with dementia. So it's the caregiver plus the dementia patient. This will be, the first meeting will be Wednesday, September 28th at 10:00 a.m. And again, that will be monthly. And then throughout the month of September, the Jack Buncher Foundation will match all donations made to any library in Allegheny County, up to $500 per each individual donor. The match pool for the month is $125,000. So I'm asking them to show your library a little love and make a donation this month. You can do it in person, by mail, through the library's website, or we have a donate button right on our Facebook page. And I'd like to thank the Jack Buncher Foundation. This is not the first time that they have supported the libraries in Allegheny County. So thank you to them. That is all I have this evening.
Any questions from council? Hearing none, thank you very much. Can we turn to the police chief's report and Chief O'Connor?
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, Council. Hello, everybody. Chief O'Connor, thank you. Thanks for coming. Just have a couple short announcements. We will be at Community Day on the 17th, along with, you see us on our public safety sector, along with fire and EMS unit will also be there because we're a team, right? Right. And we'll have the police will have some handouts, and Mr. Denson, you can bring me a coffee about 11 o'clock. Thank you. All right. Our crime watch will resume on October the 3rd, Monday at the community center. Hope to see everybody there. Stop over and find out what's going on. So we have a special guest tonight, so I'm going to introduce Officer Kerry Elwanger and our new canine officer, G's. Come on up. We've been on the road here now with the canine unit since early July this year. Kerry went to the Pittsburgh Police Academy on Washington Boulevard for a 12-week course, canine course. And after that, upon graduation, he's looking at me. They, I don't do usually with pit bulls. He graduated. He's been out on the road. They've made a couple of arrests already so far. And I'm going to give you this, and you can maybe tell a couple short sentences about him. He's still looking at me.
He thinks his microphone is poised. Well, we're lucky to have G's here. He's a great dog. He's a Belgian Malinois. He's from Holland. At this point, he's about 21 months old. He'll turn 2 in December. He's a narcotics dog. He's dual purpose, which means he does patrol work as well as sniffing out drugs for us. As you can see, he's all attentive as to the microphone. All he wants to do is play. All the training is reward-driven, which makes it very fun and very easy for the dogs. It makes them work even better for us. But we're lucky to have him, and he's going to be a great dog. Good boy. He's going to be a great dog for the department, and I think he's going to fit in well for the community here. Thank you.
All right, everybody. Thanks. Remember to follow us on Facebook. Questions?
Thank you very
thank
much.
You.
Thank you all.
Okay, we turn to the Fire Chief's report, Chief Gerber. I would like, before the Chief goes, to thank the Bethel Park Community Foundation and the Ben Roethlisberger Foundation for helping us out with the grant money to purchase the dog.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Dave Gerber. I'm the Fire Chief here in Bethel Park. To give you the Fire Chief's report for the month of August. Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company ran 34 calls in the month of August. We had one structure fire, one vehicle fire, one brush fire, one extrication, two calls for people stuck in an elevator, two calls for natural gas leaks, four calls for power lines down, one electrical condition, one tree into or onto a house, three vehicle accidents, an odor of smoke, nine fire alarms, four CO alarms, and three severe weather conditions, totaling 34 calls for the month. Coming up on October 2nd, we're having an open house down at the New Brightwood Station facility. It'll be from noon to 4. There'll be all kind of activities for the kids. There'll be free hot dogs and refreshments for everybody. Back in, was it June or July, we had our big grand opening for the new building, and that was more to show off the building. This is more for fire prevention tips and things for the kids and stuff. And also, obviously, show you around the new facility and stuff. This is more geared towards kids and teaching them fire prevention and items like that. So we hope to see you on Sunday, October 2nd. The good news is there's no Steeler game that day, so feel free to come down. We won't be bothering you for anybody missing the football game and stuff. It's the game's that evening, so. Next thing on the list, we're always looking for new members. You can check us out on Facebook. We've been posting a lot of things training-wise and all for our Monday evening trainings on Facebook. If you're interested in joining, You can go to our website, which is BethelParkVFC.com, and there's information on there for anybody who's interested in joining. If you are interested in joining, have some questions, feel free to give us a call. Stop down any Monday night to the Brightwood Fire Station. We're always there Monday evenings. More than happy to talk to you, show you around, answer any questions you have. Like I said, always looking for new members, so please feel free. I was asked, had a conversation with one of my officers the other day. I'd like to just pass this along. I'd like to remind everybody that Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Department is 100% volunteer, meaning when we have a call, we are not always at a fire station. We can be at home, at work, out shopping, wherever we might be. So when a fire call comes in, we respond to the station. So if you happen to see blue lights behind you in your mirror, we ask you please pull over, give them the right of way. They're trying to get to a fire station as quick as they can so that they can get into a fire truck and we can get onto our way. So there isn't always somebody around. I had a conversation, like I said, with one of my officers the other day. He talked to somebody over on South Park Road. We had a call, and they gave us an earful that, how come you weren't here? You're 30 seconds around the corner. It takes a couple minutes for guys to get to the fire station and stuff. So, like I said, if you see blue lights in your mirror, please pull over, get out of the way. Let the guys get to the station as quick as they can so that we can get to the emergency call as fast as we can. And the last thing on my list is donations. We ask every month, we're always looking for donations. If you're interested in donating, if you didn't receive a card in the mail, you can always go to our website. Once again, it's BethelParkVFC.com. Click on the donations link and you can send us a donation right through your computer. You don't even have to write a check or waste a stamp. So with that is all I have. And if anybody has any questions, here we go.
Yep. Okay. Hearing none, thank you very much, Chief. We can turn to the Mayor's Report and Mayor Allen.
Thank you, Chief. As the Chief mentioned, the Fire Department has their open house October 2nd. There is no football game that day. However, there is one this evening. So I should keep this to a half hour, and we should be able to get there for the fourth quarter anyhow. As Mr. Myrie said before, we lost a great friend and a councilman last week. He'll always be remembered for all the good things he did for Bethel Park over the last three plus decades. And I'm sure others will say things about John tonight, but I wanted to talk about his military service. John was a wounded World War II veteran. He was a member of our American Legion Post 760 here in Bethel Park. And he will always be grateful, will always be grateful for his service to the United States of America. We also lost another World War II veteran a couple weeks ago who was on our zoning hearing board, and that was Jack Tortorese. And so I want to, keep both of them in your prayers. They did a lot of service for Bethel, and we're going to miss them both. I'd also like to recognize a couple members of our police department for an incident that occurred last month. One of our residents had a medical condition, and three of our officers responded and saved his life. Michelle Tanney, our dispatcher, had the family on the phone the whole time until our officers got there. And those three officers were Dean Christiana, Craig Smeltz, Stephen Hosella. And in a time when the police departments are in the spotlight, I want to thank them all for all the good work they do, not just those three, but our whole police department. On a lighter note, our fall cleanup is coming. Saturday, October 15th, as in the past, PennDOT will supply the trash bags, safety vest, and gloves, and municipality will provide patches for the young participants. There's an opportunity for willing volunteers to clean up the parks and roadways of Bethel Park and spruce up our community. If any individual or group is interested in participating, they should call Michelle Bainham for details at 412-831-6800, extension 203. And to give Michelle more work to do, we have our 90-plus luncheon coming up this year. So if you know of any residents, we're trying to reach out to them. Unfortunately, we have, or we usually have it at the community center, but this year we're going to have it at St. Val's. They've been very generous to let us use their facility. And you can contact Michelle Bynum at the same number. And as the chief mentioned, Community Day is this Saturday, September 17th. The parade starts at 9 o'clock, and the festivities will start right after the parade ends over on the high school grounds. You thought I was kidding you. One other thing, we have household chemical collection. A collection event is scheduled for September 17th in Allegheny County. We'll provide Pennsylvania residents with an opportunity to safely and cost-effectively dispose of household chemicals. It'll be September 17th also from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. at the South Park Wave Pool parking lot. The cost for the materials, it will cost you $3 a gallon, cash only, but you'll be able to clean the garage out right before the winter starts. And lastly, we have an anniversary coming up at the end of this month, and if I can ask Councilwoman Means to come up. Brookside Lumber will be celebrating their 90th anniversary in Bethel Park, so I have a proclamation for them, present it to Sue since she's part of the family. And it reads as follows. Whereas Brookside Lumber was founded in 1926 by P.S. Edwards, whereas Pete and Frank, P.S. Edwards' sons, returned home after serving in World War II and joined the company in the 1940s. Whereas the third generation joined Brookside Lumber in the 1970s and continues to be involved with the operation of the company. Whereas the Brookside name was chosen because of a new residential area close to the lumber yard called Brookside Farms. And whereas because the railroad was on the side of the property, lumber was delivered by rail car and sold to the builders in the local area. And whereas a small showroom of 200 square feet was set up in the sales office that was built in the 1930s. In addition, the front of the present showroom was constructed in 1967 with a drive-through loading area in the back. And whereas today Brookside Lumber covers over 7 acres with over 100,000 square feet of product under roof. Whereas it's appropriate to recognize the significance that Brookside Lumber has had to the Bethel Park community. Therefore, I, Jack Allen, mayor of the municipality of Bethel Park, do hereby recognize Brookside Lumber's 90th anniversary on the 25th day of September, 2016. So I'll give that to you, Sue.
Family, I want to thank you for this award, and just it's been an honor to serve the community and build the community of Bethel Park for 90 years. And it was just an idea because my grandfather was a contractor, and the neighbors came and said, "Can we buy your lumber?" And that was the beginning in 1926 of the lumber company. So thank you all for your support. Thank you again.
Thank you, sir. That's my report.
Thank you very much, Mayor. If this time, could we can turn to the approval of the minutes, and Mr. Hannon.
I move that we approve the regular council meeting minutes of September 8th, 2016.
Second.
There is a motion, a second, that we approve the regular council meeting minutes of September 8th, 2016. Any discussion of this item? Mr. Spagnuolo, would you please call the roll?
Dixon?
Yes.
Hannon?
Yes.
Harrison?
Yes.
McLean?
Yes.
Mowry?
Yes.
O'Brien?
Yes.
Motion passes 7-0. Mr. Hannick, we turn to the approval of the bills and payrolls. 6-0.
I move that we approve the bills and payrolls for municipality per bill list number 091216 in the amount of $1,946,795.17.
Second.
There is a motion, a second, that we approve the bills and payrolls for the municipality per bill list number 091216 in the amount of $1,946,795.17. Any discussion of this item? Mr. Spagnuolo, would you please call the roll?
Hannon?
Yes.
Harrison?
Yes.
McLean?
Yes.
Mowry?
Yes.
O'Brien?
Yes.
Dixon?
Yes.
Motion passes 6-0. At this time, I'd like to turn to the resident comments section for non-agenda items. If you'd like to get up and stand and state your name and address for the record, we have a 3-minute limit. At the end of 2 minutes, we'll signify and ask you to conclude your comments.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I just want to say something on behalf of Mr. Pape, and I put a little bit together here today, and it's to the mayor and municipal council of the municipality of Bethel Park. I, Carl Denson, of 2615 Santa Barbara Drive in Bethel Park, want to say this. In memory of my friend, the late John A. Pape, councilman of the municipality of Bethel Park, Pennsylvania, for 31 years, I met Mr. Pape back in 1968, the Democratic Committee meeting in Bethel Park. Subsequently, Councilman Pape and I served together on a Civil Service Commission for Bethel Park. Since then, I've served personally on the commission for 30 years plus. Councilman Pape was my friend, who along with then Senator Mike Fisher, who recommended that I be appointed to the Human Relations Commission, where I served 20 years. And three of those 20 years, I served as chairman of that commission. As a councilman, Mr. Pape was generally supportive of our municipality. He was instrumental in working with senators and legislators from Harrisburg to obtain various grants and funding for our municipal region. Mr. Pape will be sadly missed, but my hope is that residents of Bethel Park will not readily forget Mr. Pape's diligent efforts to support and advance the causes of our municipality. I just want to let you know how I felt about Mr. Pape. He helped a lot of people in Bethel Park. I'll let you know we will all miss him. Thank you.
Mr. Barnes?
Mr. Harrison?
Just as a follow-up of what Mr. Denson had to say, I recommend to council that we rename Miners Memorial Park to John Pape Park in recognition of his long and dedicated service as an elected councilman representing the ward that that park is located in. Thank you.
Yeah, I would ask if the manager can place that on our next house or our next general policy and finance agenda. Thank you. Okay, are there any other residents who would like to speak? If you state your name and address for the record, please.
My name is Bob Barrett. I'm 2931 O'Neill Drive, but a 20 plus year resident up there, one of Mr. Pape's constituents. And I would like to reiterate that he's very much going to be missed by the people in that ward. And I'd like to offer whatever help I can to this council and the community. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Is there any other residents who would like to speak? Hearing none, if we can turn to the agenda.
We got one more.
One more.
I'm sorry.
My name's Ken Scherer. I live at 1005 Surrey Woods Road. I built a home there about 40-some years ago and was very happy I did, because I honestly believe that Bethel Park is one of the nicest and best communities, not only in the South Hills, but in the whole county. And that my recognition of being involved in activities when I first came here was long, long ago. And I had the greatest respect for the council. They were good men. They're all gone now. Death takes its toll. But I had a discussion with several of the people who are left on our street, that still on our street, and one of them made a statement to me, and I said, no, you can't be right. He said, oh yeah, there's a man, he said, in borough council that has served in this community for better than 30 years. And I says, nah, couldn't be. I happen to know a person who served quite a few years. But he said, no. I checked it out and I couldn't believe that you have on your council a man who has given tremendous effort to have this wonderful municipality in which we live for 43 years. And not only that, my son was a Boy Scout, and when I went to camp with him and a few other things, who did I find? I found a man who sits there, and his name, Donald Harrison. The kids loved him. He made a tremendous impact of goodness to that Boy Scout troop here in Bethel Park. In addition to that, it was more than just boys, Boy Scouts. It was the fact that he helped set a trend for the young, fine young men that were developed and that had such respect for this man. And recently, someone was talking about a new park that went up. I went up to take a look at it, and I was impressed. This Millennium Park, beautiful, beautiful. And thinking of all the things that have been going on in Bethel Park, and it dawned on me that here is a man who's probably as old as I am and is not in the best of health, putting all his time into things. 40 years with the Boy Scouts as an advisor and so forth. And I felt that it would be a wonderful, wonderful thing to get a man who's been here for 43 years and change that this group here would change the name from Millennium Park. Sometimes you get tongue-tied trying to say it. And make it the Donald Harrison Park. I think it would be a great tribute to a man who is one of the most ethical persons that I've ever met in the years that I have. So I hope that this could come about, really. He's a very ethical individual. Age is beginning to bear very heavily on his shoulders. I watched him come in, his wife. He loves, she's quite sick. And I believe that no one would be objecting that Millennium Park is named Donald Harrison Park, or even Donald Harrison Millennium Park, if someone insists on a name Millennium. All right? So that's what I ask that this group here considers, and hopefully this man will be given a wonderful gift by the people of Bethel Park. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, are there any other residents that would like to speak? Hearing none, can we turn to general policy and finance, and Mr. McLean?
Mr. Chairman, we have no agenda items under general policy and finance for this evening.
Thank you, Mr. McLean. Any budget update, Mr. McLean?
I can give a budget update.
Perfect.
As required, we have been provided with a preliminary budget by the finance director. It's been provided to members of council. We are going to conduct our first meeting review of it 2 weeks from tonight at the end of September. We go through a process of reviewing that budget, updating it as we go. But can let folks know that as of now anyway, the preliminary budget does not propose any increase in taxes for the 2017 fiscal year. But we'll continue to keep the public advised as we move forward with respect to our review of the budget. It will be available for review in the library. And if anyone has any questions, you can address it to us, and we will have a public meeting on the budget as well before its adoption.
Thank you, Mr. McLean, for your update. I only have one announcement. It's a little difficult to do, but I think is required by the Home Rule Charter. Council discussed this evening that we have a vacancy in Ward 1. We will be advertising for people to send their letter of interest and resume. I believe they need to be a resident of the ward as well as a registered voter to apply. To send your letter of interest and resume to Mr. Spagnol, care of municipality of Bethel Park. The cutoff is going to be Thursday, September 29, 2016 at 12 noon. and we plan on interviewing on Wednesday, October 5th, 2016. So this will also be advertised. Are there any additional items? Hearing none, can we turn to planning and zoning? And Mr. Dixon, we have no residents signed up to speak.
Thank you, Mr. President. We have one item under planning and zoning tonight, and that is signals in coordination with equipment upgrades agreement, the sync up agreement. I move that the appropriate municipal official execute the agreement with Southwestern Pennsylvania Commission for the traffic signal improvement project along McMurray Road.
Second.
There is a motion to second that we that the appropriate municipal official execute the agreement with Southwestern Pennsylvania Commission for the traffic signal improvement project along McMurray Road. Any discussion of this item? Mr. Spagnuolo, would you please call the roll?
Harrison?
Yes.
McLean?
Yes.
Mowry?
Yes.
O'Brien?
Yes.
Dixon?
Yes.
Hannon?
Yes.
Motion passes 6-0. Mr. Dixon.
That's all we have under planning and zoning tonight, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Dixon. Are there any additional items? Hearing none, we turn to health, safety, and welfare, and Mr. O'Brien.
Thank you, Mr. Meyer. There are no items under health, safety, and welfare.
Mr. O'Brien, thank you. Are there any additional items?
Mr. Chairman, I have one.
Mr. O'Brien.
This afternoon, we say goodbye to a great friend of Bethel Park, John Albert Pape, a.k.a. also known as Johnny Crusher, the governor. And on St. Patrick's Day, when I decorated a yard, he was known as John Patrick O'Pape, the keeper of the pot of gold. What an amazing man. He had the ability to light up a room. With Paul Dixon, paraphrased, the John-isms. You got that right, brother. More people died of pneumonia. I just didn't fall out of no Christmas tree. I'm too old of a cat to be followed by a kitten. He was just a funny guy. He could make people laugh. Everyone knew Johnny Pape. For over 40 years, he served as the 1st Ward Councilman. When work needed to be done, Johnny was always there. He was not the kind of guy to pick up a shovel. His greatest tool was the telephone. He would say, "I'm burning up the wires, brother." And he would know someone somewhere who knew somebody who knew someone. He would just get it done. He was not much of a public speaker, however, one-on-one, wow, Johnny was at his best. As his son Gregory said this afternoon, John was always looking for a deal. John was a true salesman. He just didn't look for a deal for Bethel Park, he worked for deals. He could find common ground and compromise. That's just the way he was. That's just what he did. There was two things that John did not care much for. One was losing, the other was the word no. And many of us were on the other side, over the years, have been on that side of John. And we know John could be very difficult with those two issues. He would never give up. He would just work so hard to change your mind or give you a different perspective until the vote was taken. And once it was done, John would move on. John was not afraid of anything or anybody. He is part of the greatest generation. John came from Mount Wash. He grew up on that Cheese Street in the Depression. They were difficult times. You had to be tough, and that's what John was. My father also grew up in Mount Washington, and I didn't know that when I first, that John and my dad knew each other, because my dad was already gone. John would tell me stories about my father and his childhood from the old days. When I first came on council, I was up visiting my grave, my father and mother's grave up on Mount Washington, so I made a unique observation. When I come home and I called Johnny up, I said, "John, do you know some guy named Anaclita Pape?" He said, "Hey, look, tall glass of water, I'm gonna clean your clock. What are you making fun of my father for?" I said, well, wait a minute, brother. John's father and my father are buried side by side in St. Anne's Cemetery. John had a great passion for veterans, and he didn't really share much that he was a wounded combat veteran of World War II. When you talk to John about his stories of the war, he brought a lot of good stories of joy and his friendship and his travels through the Philippines and the Upper Luzon. But there's one time when John was in combat, he lost his best friend beside him. He was gone, and that's when John was wounded. And that's all the information I would get, because John would start to weep and say, I do not wish to ever talk about this again. And don't you share this while I'm still here. So tonight I share that. John just loved to help people. Jobs, getting jobs if they're in trouble. He was willing to reach out. He was a great defender of his beloved people of Ward 1. He took really good care of them. John loved his children. No matter how many difficulties they found themselves in, John was always there for them. He never abandoned them. In my most difficult times in my life, John was there for me every day and every time. And John had a deep love for his wife, Audrey. In these days, when Audrey fell to some difficulties, John never left her side. He was her greatest hero. Bethel Park will miss this tough guy from Mount Wash. I'll miss my friend. All of us are grateful for his dedication to our country and our community. My father once said that he would never second question the Lord. However, he would like to have a long talk with him. In John's case, the Lord's having a long talk with him, and it's probably will go on for some time. Goodbye, my old friend, John Albert Pape. The Veterans Memorial is flying an Army flag in the front in remembrance of our friend John Albert Pape, Staff Sergeant John Albert Pape. The geraniums in front were donated by Dupree's Nursery, and all the wonderful bouquets that you see in the memorial today are from John's funeral. So his memory will live on, and we can honor him just one more time. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. O'Brien. I just want to have, I don't know what more I can say, but I know that the conversation that Mr. Pape is having with the Lord about now is somebody's going to end up with new carpeting, I can tell you that. No, I met John 20-plus years ago. It's hard to believe that I've been here. Some would probably say too long, but very interesting. Some of his sayings we could share, and some of them we're going to keep in our memory, but they're all good, though. He was always there to help people. I don't know how many times I got a phone call early Saturday morning. He says, hey, what are you doing? I said, I don't know. He says, why don't you come over? So I go over, and he says, come on with me. And he had a call from one of his residents that had an issue. And he wanted me, or he would do it himself, to go with them to make sure that resident was taken care of. Knowing people, as Mark said, and no matter where you went, John knew everybody. We didn't never knew how, but he knew everybody. But he was always willing to help. And I think the statutes of limitation has run out, but we at one time had a problem with one of our regulatory agencies. And we weren't getting anywhere, and they were threatening to fine us. And somebody sitting in this room, who John knew very well, knew somebody up in Erie that knew somebody in Harrisburg. And within a half hour of making that phone call, everything was resolved, and it was the best for everybody. He'll be remembered as a friend, as a member of council for over 40 years, a member of civil service for, I believe, 12 years. No matter where he went or what he did, at Bethel Park always came first for John. He may be gone, but he'll never be forgotten. Is there any other discussion? Hearing none, can we turn to Public Works and Maintenance and Mr. Hannon?
We have no agenda items under Public Works and Maintenance, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Hannan. Any additional items? Hearing none, can I have a motion to adjourn?
Move we adjourn.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned. Good night, everyone.
Go Steelers.